Hello guys, it's me CriticalCubing, and today I am going to show you how you can make your own magnetic cube. Personally, I made a magnetic GTS, but I will show you how you can do it for any of the cubes like Valk, Thunderclap, and so on. The main thing that you need to understand is how magnets work, then decide on the placement, and lastly just glue the magnets down. I'm pretty late at making this video, as at first I didn't want to make it, but over time people asked me to do it, so I did. Before we get on into the tutorial, first I will give you my thoughts on magnetic cubes. The difference between a normal cube and a magnetic cube will mainly be in its stability. Hence, it will be easier to maintain the cubic shape and the chances of overshooting will be lesser. Apart from stability, I don't see any other advantage to it. When the magnets are pulling the layers together, it's not strong and quite subtle. You won't feel the magnets when you are solving fast. However, when you go slow, you can feel the magnets and how they enter and exit the magnetic field and so on. The only reason I would make a magnetic cube is to make cubes heavy and control unstable cubes like GTS. I like heavy cubes and magnets add weight to the cube. Magnets increase the weight by 9 to 10 grams. Magnetic cube is nothing revolutionary that will instantly make you faster. However, it's definitely something innovative. The three main steps to making any normal cube a magnetic cube are these. Step 1. Select a cube and disassemble it. Step 2. Get your magnets and decide placement. Step 3. Glue the magnets down and assemble. The only difficult thing will be deciding the placement. But once you understand the concept behind the magnets, the placement isn't anything tough. Now that I have said all this, let's get on to the tutorial. Before I start, thanks to Karl for making such a wonderful guide on magnetic cubes. I followed his guide and it worked perfectly. You can find his guide in the description. The first thing that you need to do is gathering the materials. You will need a cube, magnets and optional tweezers, a pencil and super glue. Now for the magnets. You have to decide if you want weaker magnets or more powerful magnets. There are three magnetic strengths that I found commonly available. The N35, which is pretty weak and light magnet. The N50, which is what I thought of using. It's more stronger than N35 and it's suitable for my style. Lastly, there is N52, which is the strongest between these three and what I am using. GTS was unstable for me, hence I just went for stronger magnets. Once you have decided on a strength, you need size. There are two sizes that I will recommend, 4x1.5mm or 4x2mm. These seem to fit good on 57mm as well as 55mm cubes. You will need 48 magnets, hence buying a pack of 50 magnets will be a good idea. Oh, and the magnets are neodymium rare earth strong magnet, and I got them for less than $2 pack of 50 magnets. So it's nothing extraordinary costly that you cannot afford, like $15 or something like that. The first step is to disassemble the cube, and different cube will have different ways of disassembling them. You can figure them out or watch a video on them. Personally, I used a GTS here and the caps just come off, so there was no real need to disassemble mine. However, for something like a Valk, you will need to disassemble. Even for a Thunderclap, you will need to disassemble. Next step will be deciding on the placement. Generally, you will need to place 3 magnets on the corner piece and 2 on the edges. Magnet placement is easy enough. I first start with the corner and place them near the ridges on the corner piece. For the GTS, there are 3 sides that are divided by the ridge. You place your magnet near that ridge. For the edge piece, you will need to place it relative to the corner piece. You put one on the bottom of the edge piece and the one on the top. One very important thing to take note of is the polarity of the magnet. Opposites will attract and similar will repel. You need to place your magnets relative to each other so they attract and not repel. For this, an easy workaround I did was to color the north pole with black marker and the pole which was not colored was south. Then I could just place the magnets relative to each other. Before you glue the magnets down, make sure to play around with these poles and make sure that they are correct. Personally, on the corner piece, out of the 3 magnets, I messed up the pole on 1 magnet, which I rectified and made the poles attract. Test out your poles before you glue them down. Once you have made sure that the polarities are correct and the placement is proper, you can just go ahead and glue the magnets down. Be sure to ask help from your parents. A funny thing happened to me. While I was gluing the magnets, I was doing it pretty inefficiently. I first put a dab of glue, then put a magnet, and then used the pencil to get the magnet to the proper place and so on. This method is slow and tiring and inefficient most of all. My dad saw me doing this inefficient method, so he taught me a better method. I could place and glue all 48 magnets within half an hour with his method. I felt so stupid for not thinking about his method before. That's why, ask your parents for help. They just might show you a better way, as they are more wiser and more knowledgeable than you are. My dad also helped me with the polarity of the magnets. If he didn't catch my problem and correct it, this project would have been a big blunder. Thanks, Dad. And as for what I did for gluing them quickly, that's a secret. Teehee! Anyway, once you have glued the magnets down, there's nothing much to do. Let it sit idle for some time and let the glue dry. I use quick dry glue, so my glue dried down quickly, but your glue may not. Gluing was the most easiest step for me, thanks to my dad's method. Also, while you are gluing, I found it much more better to just glue the corners first and then the edges. Once you are done gluing the magnets, you are pretty much done with your magnetic cube. You should have used 48 magnets, 3 magnets each for the corner, and 2 magnets each for the edges. You can assemble your cube and try out your new magnetic cube. Now, how much did it cost me? And how much time did I spend? GTS cost me less than $15. 50 magnets cost me less than $2. Glue was less than $1. I spent less than an hour doing the whole magnetizing process. It's pretty easy and DIY friendly, according to me. Now, do you really need a magnetic cube? Personally, I much rather improve my skill and turning style than relying on something like magnets. But that's just me. I personally don't think that you need a magnetic cube. It's not something revolutionary that will instantly drop your times to world-class average. However, if you have bad turning style and you lock up, magnetizing the cube will be helpful. I also recommend magnetizing very unstable cubes like GTS. GTS for me was unstable, and with magnets it's much more stable. However, I will still use my normal non-magnetic valk over the magnetic GTS. Now for Roo users, do you need a magnetic cube? Personally, I cannot say for sure. The M slices are a bit difficult with the magnets than without the magnets, but probably using weak magnets like N35 will be helpful for Roo users. Lastly, should you be making your own magnetic cube or should you be buying it? Yup, why not? If you feel that you can do it yourself and you don't have the budget to buy a GTSM or a Valk-M and you already have the cube, then make your own. It's not much costly also, and it can be done fairly quickly. However, if you don't know what you are doing, you may mess up your cube. Hence why I said to play around with the magnets and get the polarity correct before you glue them down. I personally am pretty happy with how I made my magnetic cube, and overall I'm quite glad with the end result. And as far as buying a magnetic cube, it's your money first of all, spend it how you want to spend it. So that decision is completely lies upon you, decide for yourself. Anyway, that wraps up my tutorial for magnetic cube. The process will be same for all the cubes apart from the placement and the disassembly process. The placement, however, will be similar to the one that I'm currently using. Thank you to Karl for making the guide that I followed and for replying and giving me advice. You can check out his blog in the description. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Take care, guys, and bye. And I have to apologize for not filming my entire magnetizing process. Teehee!